So in the last video, you have learned how to calculate the average atomic mass. Now we will learn how to calculate the percentage of isotopes if average atomic mass is given to you in the question. Again, this is an important concept, so I'll mark it as important. Okay, so formula which is used is, it says formula will remain same, that is the same formula which we have used to calculate the average atomic mass. Formula says average atomic mass is equal to molar mass of isotope into percentage abundance. Okay, so now over here you will be provided with the average atomic mass and you have to calculate the percentage abundance of each isotope. In the previous video, it was that percentage abundance was given to you and you were supposed to calculate the average atomic mass. ठीक है, पहले वाले वीडियो में क्या था कि आपको परसेंटेज अबंडेंस गिवन था और आपको एवरेज एटॉमिक मास निकालना था. इन दिस वीडियो व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न, इन दिस वीडियो आपको एवरेज एटॉमिक मास दिया है और परसेंटेज अबंडेंस कैलकुलेट करना है. ओके, सो लेट्स सी एन एग्जांपल. सपोज दिस इज माय क्वेश्चन वन. क्वेश्चन सेज एवरेज एटॉमिक मास ऑफ एन एलिमेंट पी इज 16.2 U. What are the percentage of isotopes P16-8 and P18-8? So there are two isotopes which are given to you, P16-8 and P18-8 in the sample, and you are provided with the average atomic mass. See, you have to observe it very carefully because maximum times these type of questions are asked in exams. So what I will do, because I have to calculate the percentage, you people might be knowing, as in mathematics we do, similar type of calculations we'll do over here as well. I will consider the percentage of first isotope to be X percent. What is the percentage for the first isotope? It is X percent. So obviously, if the first isotope is X percent, the second isotope will be 100 minus X percent. Okay? Now, in the question itself, we are given with the average atomic mass. Average atomic mass is given as 16.2 U, as we can refer from the question. And now, since you people are aware about the concepts of atomic number, mass number, so you can see molar mass will be how much? 16 for the first one and 18 for the second one. That is equivalent to the mass number. 16 for the first one, 18 for the second one. So now I will just apply the formula. Formula says average atomic mass is equal to molar mass into percentage abundance. Everything, data, everything is ready. Simply I have to multiply, add, and then find out the value of X. So how I will do it? Average atomic mass is given to me as 16.2. Molar mass of the first isotope is 16. So 16 into X by 100. Why we have written by 100? Because over here we have used X percentage. So whenever we use percentage, that means we divide by 100. So first molar mass is 16. 16 into percentage abundance. Percentage abundance is how much? X. So I will write X by 100. Plus second molar mass is 18. 18 into 100 minus X, because the second abundance I have kept it as 100 minus X percent. So that will be 100 minus X by 100. Then obviously you'll solve it. It will become 16X by 100. You can see the steps. It will become 18 into 100 minus X by 100, and this will be equivalent to 16.2. If I'll take the LCM, this will be this will move towards this side, so it will become 1620. 16.2 multiplied by 100, it will give you 16,620 is equal to 1800 minus 2x. When you will solve this equation, you will get this value, 1800 minus 2x. Obviously, now I'm going to calculate the value of X. So I'll subtract 1620 from 1800 and divide it by 2. This is simple mathematics which you people already know. When we solve the algebraic equation, we do all these type of steps. So I don't have to elaborate these steps. Simply you need to understand what formula we are applying, how we are applying and how we are calculating the percentage value. So x is equal to how much? 90%. So from here I can derive the conclusion that my first isotope is how much? 90%. And since for second isotope I have kept the formula 100 minus x percentage, so that will be 100 minus 90, that will give me 10%. So 90% of p16 8 is present and 10% of p18 8 is present in the sample, in the given sample. So kindly revisit the videos whenever you feel like that you are not able to recall the concept, because this particular topic is very much important from grade 9th point of view.